Guys, lovely to meet you. How are you doing?
Great.
Pretty well.
Yeah?
Yeah, can't complain.
Does that influence you when you go back into the studio, having been playing gigs and, you know, the venues you've played? When you return to the studio, you go, right, we should try and do that with this album.
It does. It's in so much that we don't really like to record anything that we can't play live. We can't recreate live, so we don't add any, like, keyboard lines or backup singers or, you know, bongo solos or anything like that.
I'm you guys are held up as icons of cool. Who do you think?
And this interview is slowly dispelling that myth.
Now that this interview is out and you're not cool anymore, what is it like being has-beens of a cool avant-garde?
Cheeky smile for
nothing, because he just
he was just
filming me while I was fixing my crotch to be exact.
How's your crotch now? Is it good?
Yeah, it's better.
Yeah.
Can we get a crotch shot right now?
Right back.
album number three, was it different to when you were recording the other two? Was it easier?
I wouldn't say it was easier. I'd say it was a lot of fun, but there were, like, you know, stressful periods in time, I guess. Like everything else that you do right, you know, you go through a range of emotions.
Okay. Quiet one now. Dead silent, to be exact.
Responsible for a huge resurgence in, like, indie music in the UK. What do you think of some of the bands that have emerged since then?
Is it a band called The Cribs?
Yeah.
Are they from the UK?
Yes, they are, yeah. Sheffield, I think. Yeah. Up north.
I heard a song of theirs that was pretty good.
How does the music coming out of London at the moment, like, or even the UK, compare to what's going on in New York?
The greatest, like, music that's coming out of North America is, like, you know, the Kings of Leon from Nashville and...
That's the South, but...
Yeah, that's...
Oh, North America.
Arcade Fire from Canada. Harmar lives in L.A., Harmar Superstar.
Yeah, it's New York.
Yeah. Michael Jackson lives in Neverland Ranch.
Not anymore, he's actually moving to the Middle East, yeah. So...
Oh.
Really?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Does it feel special, like playing completely live as opposed to...
We always play completely live. We've never played half live. None of us have ever died or been in a coma. We never use any kind of playback or anything like that. We've never really done that.
Except for shooting the video.
We did it once, actually, when we shot our video, when we were filming our video.
Never did it.
In front of an audience or anything, no.
Do you ever sort of throw something different in there, like when you play, just to sort of... for a spontaneous moment?
Julian likes to take away my hi-hat right when I'm playing.
Wait! Enjoying London? Does it vaguely feel like home, apart from the lack of pizza?
Yeah. You know what? The funny thing is, like, at first, it's very weird for you, I guess, for me. But then you start to get used to it, and you know the places that you like to go, and it feels more and more like home, and it's nice.
Is there one place you always look forward to going back to?
Glasgow.
Yeah?
I like Glasgow. Crowds are very nice in Glasgow. Actually, they're not nice. They're crazy.
Yeah.
fans expect from the new album in terms of, I mean, are they going to be surprised by it?
What's your favorite song, Julian? I think people are going to be surprised.
No. What's your favorite song off this new album?
I don't know.
Come on, pick one. It doesn't matter.
That was
the
last question.
You only live once. Yeah.
Why?
Oh, God. Because the balance of rhythm and melody. No, I don't know. I don't have a favorite song.
Heard it here, folks. You only live once. Take it, JC.
And the media have often like sort of focused on your fashion and the way you look as much as they have your music, and sometimes more so. It's been about like what the Strokes are wearing. Is it something that you've been like, have you felt uncomfortable with that?
So Julian, who are you wearing?
Well, this is D&G, the jacket. The shoes are Hector Camacho.
Oh, he's one of my favorite designers, yeah. Hector Camacho.
I think he was a boxer, but now he designs shoes.
Right.
It's actually our B-side. That's as deep as I'm going to go. It's a B-side, just some B-side. It's called Hawaii.
Listen to the back of the loop with the Uran New York.
much as, you know, 4 years can allow you to grow up, we're all a little bit more responsible, I guess. Not as abusive to ourselves.
But you still have the spirit of rock and roll inside.
Yeah, I hope so.
I'm dead inside.
What advice would you give to that kid in his bedroom, listening to The Strokes, who wants to make music?
Give it up, kid.
Anything more inspirational?
So mean.
I would say you gotta work really hard.
Learn an instrument.
Or just get wasted and act all rock and roll-y.
Yeah, I'd say focus on like being a good musician as opposed to like being a rock star before you're even...
But kick some ass, though, on the way.
Oh, yeah, Happy New Year, man. Yeah, Happy fucking New Year. Yeah, you missed Thanksgiving there, buddy. Yes. Whoa, it's hot in here. The stairs... burning me.